Okay, Michael, what'd you come up with?
I have a bunch. Well, so the big advantage of RCA, it's cheap.
It is cheap.
It's simple.
It is simple.
It's easy.
It is easy in a sort of common glory of complexity sense.
Sort of practically free. Those are all words like free, easy. Those are the words that came to mind. You're saying that that's none of those is your word.
No, none of those was the word that I was
How about
coming up with.
works?
No. It did start with the letter F, though.
Famous.
No.
Foul-mouthed.
That's two words.
Friendly.
No.
All right, I need more letters. I'm still going back to famous. Fabulous. Fast.
That's right, it's fast. But I would definitely give you cheap or easy.
Cheap is like fast.
So it's easy.
All right.
At least that's what the slang term meant where I grew up. Anyway, okay, so anything that captures fast, cheap, easy, whatever would do here. But what's irritating about this, and actually things like k-means and knn and a whole bunch of other algorithms, is that they're so freaking simple, and yet they manage to work. And that can be kind of annoying sometimes because, as machine learning people, we want to come up with these complex things that work. But as a very brilliant man once said to me, you must earn your complexity. So RCA, randomized components analysis, or really randomized projections, has this very simple way of thinking about the world. I'll just randomly throw things together, and it turns out to pick up correlations along the way and work pretty well. And its big advantage, other than working sometimes, is that it's very, very fast. PCA can take hours in supercomputers, and ICA can take hours upon hours in even more supercomputers. But generating a bunch of random numbers, computers are really good at that, and it happens to go really, really fast.